Hello everybody, my name is Anjasta Balakrishna, I'm a legal intern of Lexis & Company, and today I'm going to talk about the essential elements of partnership under the Indian Partnership Act. The Indian Partnership Act 1932 governs partnerships that are formed as a consequence of a contract between two parties. So basically, defines partnership under Section 4 as a relationship between two people who have agreed to do a business or share profits in a business that is carried out by all of them or one of them on behalf of the all the other partners. And in cases where the Partnership Act is silent or where there are provisions in the contract where Partnership Act is silent, then the law would of the Indian Contract Act would be applicable. So there are different elements that are needed in order for a partnership to be valid. However, the three basic and the three important yet basic elements are that it should be an agreement between parties. The objective must be to make profit and to divide that profit among partners. And the agreement must state that the business would be carried out either jointly or by one partner who does the business on behalf of all the others. Excuse me. These are the basic yet important elements. However, in these three elements itself, there are different wordings that has to be explained or that has to be understood in a more clearer manner, because each word is kind of quite important when it comes to the elements. So the first element, as I mentioned, was that it must be an agreement between the parties. So the explanation or the extended version would be that there should be a particular number of members in order for a partnership to be valid. So partnership can be formed by two or more people, and though the Partnership Act specifically does not provide a maximum minimum number of partners, the Companies Act definitely provides a maximum minimum, and it's stated that it would be a minimum of two and a maximum of 100, and if the maximum limit is surpassed, then there would be action taken by the court under Section 464 of the Companies Act 2013. So that is the first element. Second one is that the agreement. There should be an agreement between both the parties who have chosen to do the partnership, and the agreement should be that they should share the profits and loss equally. So as I mentioned before, the three major elements, it was mentioned that there should profits and loss should be shared equally. That is the that comes under the factor of agreement. The partnership agreement must establish a legal connection between the partner and must serve as a foundation or the basis or the framework of the whole project, because basically all the factors of the agreement must be followed, and an agreement is essential for it to be legal or for the legal framework of the partnership. And an agreement can be an oral agreement or a written agreement, but a written agreement is more preferable when it comes to legal actions, and a written agreement would be known as a partnership deed. So the next element is business, and it's mentioned in Section 12 of the Act, which states that the partnership must be formed with the intention or with the sole purpose of carrying out a lawful business. Co-ownership or co-ownership does not exist or does not constitute partnership. The intention or the main obligation must be to conduct a business and to gain profit, and it should not be for other purposes or private matters. So the next element is mutual agency. Mutual agency is provided under Section 13 of the Act, and it states that the business would be handled by all the partners. As we mentioned the beginning of the three essential elements, it was stated that the partnership would be handled by all the partners jointly or one on the basis of other. That is what is stated in mutual agency that comes under Section 13, that one partner or all the one partner would do the business or the partnership on behalf of the others. So all the partners jointly would carry out the business, and they would have the authority over the company. So basically, each partner should have an authority over the company, and between the partners, there must be a mutual agency. Each partner should serve the purpose, so should be both the principal as well as the agent. So basically, there must be a mutual agency among the different partners. The next element is sharing of profits. Profits and losses must be divided among the partners as per as the agreement provided. And profit and loss distribution can be based upon the capital contribution or percentage, or can be distributed equally. So basically, there are two methods in order to to share the profits. If you have studied accountancy before, you might know that. And if you have not studied, then I will explain to you in a brief manner. You can share the profit depending upon the capital that you spend. Now, if you have provided the capital on a basis of 3:2:1 and there are three partners, then the profit would be divided in the same manner, 3:2:1. But if you have already agreed that to share the profit in an equal manner, that is 1:1:1, then it can be followed in that manner too. But if there's no agreement that it will be shared equally, then it will be shared on the basis of capital distribution. The last element is that the liability of partnership, that is, all partners must be responsible for the firm's debts and for the firm's liabilities. And this liability is considered to be limitless, which means that even the personal assets of the partners can be sold or can be used in order to satisfy the firm's obligation. Basically, the liability must be equally divided, equally shared. It's not only the profits, but also the losses that has to be equally shared. And these losses would be covered with the help of the personal assets too. So these are the different elements of partnership under the Partnership Act. But basically, as I mentioned before, there are three main elements, and those elements or the wordings of those elements are extended or expanded in order to understand partnership in a better manner. So I hope that you can understand the elements related to Partnership Act, because any of us can be a part of a partnership or can be a part of an agreement or contract. And when you decide to be a part of an agreement or contract, or when you decide to be a partner of a firm, it's important that you understand these elements, or you know, you try to make sure these elements are fulfilled in order for your partnership to be valid. So I hope that you could understand the video. If you like the video, please press the like and subscribe button to get more law related videos in the upcoming days. Thank you for visiting the channel. I hope you have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you.